Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to introduce a Russian bishop. They call him Metropolitan. And his name is Anthony of Sourozh. And he used to be a doctor and who took on to the priesthood, and he was a nice man. He had put up many sermons, and they are worth reading, and you could be put on his mailing list. I send all the mail I got today, and there he was mentioning some gospel. And I just read it through. So today we have in the gospel a short example of the way in which we most of the time receive gifts of God. 10 men came covered with leprosy, condemned to a cruel death by illness, but also rejected ritually by their own people for the impurity of this infectious disease. They came to him, Christ Jesus, stood at a distance because they knew that according to the Jewish law, they had no right even to come near him, to touch him. And they asked for mercy, and God sent them to the priests to bring forth the sign of their gratitude for the healing which they had received, which they had not received, and they believed. And they went and they were healed before they reached their goal. We might have expected that they rushed back to fall to the feet of Christ Jesus to touch him in gratitude. No, 9 of them went their way. It was enough for them to have been healed. And remember, those 9, they were Jewish people. And Jewish people, as you know, they believed in their own rabbi better than the Christ Jesus. So they wanted to make sure that this credit goes to their rabbi and not to Christ Jesus. So they rushed back to their rabbi for him to get the credit. But there was one who was a Gentile. It is all they needed of God. One of them, however, turned around and came to thank. He said, "Lord, you know, but our brother Christ Jesus, you know." So the one who turned back was a Gentile. As you know, the Gentile, they are very thankful people. They are the living people. And that's why St. Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So he was a man of spirit, this Gentile. So he came back to thank our brother Christ Jesus. Well, the others, they had no spirit. They were just wanted to read Torah, written Torah, dry of the spirit. So they went back to their rabbi, their teacher, moral teacher, and they did not appreciate what Christ Jesus had done to them. So this is a typical example of the Jews. They are not thankful to Jesus. Their hearts are in their written Torah. That's why these Messianic Jews, when you go to their churches, you can see how proudly they will turn back to their written Torah, Old Testament, and start reading from them more vigorously and more eagerly than the New Testament. So thus this is their nature. They are proud and they are stiff-necked. because they have got this written Torah, which is a rotten one, as Jesus said, the old cloth had dwelt holes, which is useless, but they are keeping it over their head, and they condemned the New Testament. So much so that they pushed the apostles out of the Judea region first before any other church pushed them out. And with a sycophancy, they lured the Roman emperors, and when Roman Emperor Constantine was in their pocket, then they start killing people who were men of spirit, the apostles, whom they have rejected. So that's how they killed Christianity. So this sermon by this Russian bishop, they are quite interesting, and they give you more insight into the gospel than any other sermon you will find. And if you find anything better, please let me know. And as you know, these people who are doctors and all that, who become the servants of God, they are sincere. They are not working for money. They are working to serve people. So he is a typical example of a Russian doctor who turned to serving people. Although he put on that robes and all that, which is of Antichrist. But as you know, they are mostly blind to spirit, but their hearts are in God, like Saul. They are like Saul, and they need to be turned into Paul. So that's why I go to these Greek Orthodox church to see that if I can infuse some of the spirit into them. So he has a list of, there's an English version, which is in the description I have put it. And if you click at the link and go to the library or the sermons, and you will find one which is on Saint Fortina. You just put Saint Fortina in the search engine there, in the search over there, and you will find the articles he has written. Remember that in 1983, when I read the New Testament and John's Gospel, I could identify that these five husbands of the woman, they are not physical, they are spiritual, which she had overpowered. In 1983, I wrote an article on that one, giving the names of the husbands of the Samaritan woman, and took it to the local priest to have a look at it. And to my surprise, I said, hey, there's no mention of these names in the Bible. So where from you got it? He was a bit, taken aback. And he took me for a heretic or something wrong with my head, This man, nothing in the Bible, and he comes here telling me these are the names. As the other day to a Greek Orthodox priest, when he was giving the sermon on the marriage of the son, when all were gathered together, one was not properly dressed. And I told him his name was Judah Iscariot. He said, but it is not written there. Then I gave him cross reference to the Last Supper, when he was thrown out of the party. So Christ Jesus is the light. So when he was thrown out, he was thrown out into the darkness where he repented. And then he was a bit, surprised and hope. Let's see, these people are a bit educated and they are more devoted than the British clerics. And see what we can do with them. And hope our brethren will listen to me. And I'm going to Mount Athos Let's see what happens. God bless you.